Can you what?
How far are we away from the hotel?
What they do is, those on those they go like out, they cruise.
You can go gambling on it.
Five, was it 12 miles international waters, and they open up casinos.
Oh,
yeah,
right. If you're looking at over there, the Holiday at a Carmel.
Wow.
We come over, they have an outfit called Cruise Connection that meets all the chefs at the outdoor of the St. Living. And
who could we use as bait? Is that a boy? It's a gull.
Oh, look at the two next door. Look at the two next to it. They've got penguins, I think, aren't they?
Penguins. I've got him. I got him.
Pelicans.
We rode here. We stayed up for
Miami, Florida. Happy New Year, and welcome to the National Broadcasting Company's exclusive coverage of the 61st Annual King Orange Jamboree Parade, hosted by Joe Namath and Faith Daniel. And to get 1995 off to a spectacular start, here's the multi-talented singer, dancer, and actress, Susan Anton.
On a tropical island, in the middle of the ocean,
is proud to present the 61st Annual King Orange Jamboree Parade with your hosts, Joe Namath and Faith Daniel, with special guests, Miss America Heather Whitestone, country singing sensation Colin Ray, rock legends KC and the Sunshine Band, Randy Bachman and the Bachman Band. New wave calypso artist, Arrow. Tonight's Grand Marshal, racing legend Emerson Fittipaldi. And once again, Susan Anton.
This next band is living proof of how much energy you have when you're young. The Lincoln High School Marching Band from Lincoln, Nebraska arrived in Miami earlier today after leading the Christmas Festival Parade at Walt Disney's Magic Kingdom.
Under the direction of Terry Rush and Dan Ely, the tireless marching Lynx are performing selections by Cole Porter.
Band members. They're a long way from Nebraska. But they're in town for the big game. I wonder if they have tickets.
Oh, I'll bet they do.
If they don't, I'll tell them you'll get them for them, Faith.
Thanks, Jeff.
And Super Bowl tickets, too, will be available by Faith Daniels. Everyone in Pittsburgh, give her a call. She has 30 tickets to the game.
If our Steelers make it there, I'll be begging for tickets myself. What's the chance that they get two Pittsburghers up in this booth in Miami, huh? You from Beaver Falls and me from Little Washington.
I think there's a better chance of the Steelers making it to the Super Bowl. They've done it before, of course.
Now you've got one of those rings yourself, don't you,
there? Yes, ma'am.
In a shoe. Well, this is the 90s, and even she has to keep up with the time, so she packed up all her kids and moved them into where else but a rollerblade.
Kind of a mobile home, huh?
You could say that. Sponsored by the Miami Herald, this 15-foot skate is plenty big enough for the 8-foot-tall woman and her 20 children. It gives me heart palpitations just to think about it. You can see some of the kids peeking out of the windows, the rest of them are blading alongside.
On the stage right behind the blade is 13-year-old Nicole Purdy of Plantation, Florida. Now, Nicole is giving us a demonstration of the technique that earned her the crown at the 1994 U.S. Figure Skating Association South Florida Atlantic Regional Competition.
I don't think the ice would hold up here in Miami in 74-degree weather.
Thank you. And what would you be doing? Kicking?
No.
Kicking at the bully?
The bully?
You go away.
I gotcha. Angie.
A boat is pulling.
What are you building, JT?
Castle.
All right. What is it? Wait a second, let me get it focused. Pull it back here, sir.
I have a color.
You know where you're at, huh?
Yeah.
Is my major doing a stay watch diet?
Raise your hands. That is neat.
It's your face right there.
Oh,
yeah.
You haven't quite got the head yet. Do you have any words to say like glug, glug? Let's see. Does your nose itch? Think about this. Does your nose itch?
No.
Is there sand in your face?
A bit. Oh, there's sand in his eyes.
I can barely hear.
I can see that. What?
What are you doing? Oh my god.
I know.
We gotta get that on film. You like the beach?
To, like, what? I'm having fun at the beach. Oh.
Where you been?
Shopping.
We went shopping.
We had to get lipstick for a
hot man's point of being scared, but I think Milan was pretty scared.
What you doing, JT?
Well, I kind of kept looking over my shoulder.
Well, at least you guys had strength.
You know, when the streets are clearing out, we were the only ones left, and we were walking up and down looking.
Probably about 3. Did you make them? Say you made them. Good job, JT.
balmy winter's night, you might call it hurricane weather. Tonight, in their home stadium, the Orange Bowl, where they have won 62 of their last 63 games, the number 3 Miami Hurricanes beat number 1 and undefeated Nebraska, seeking to become college football's national champions. It's another sellout of 78,000 for this 61st Orange Bowl game. And although the Nebraska Cornhuskers may have one of their finest teams ever, and though you'll see plenty of Nebraska supporters clad in red tonight, this is still their formidable task. To win here, in this Miami sound machine, where the Hurricanes have lost only once since 1985, and but for a single bad quarter against Washington back in September, the Hurricanes would themselves be undefeated and poised to win their fifth national title in 12 seasons. As it is, Miami does have a slim chance to win the title, but the Canes must beat the Cornhuskers tonight and hope that somehow number 2 Penn State loses to Oregon in tomorrow's Rose Bowl. Only Nebraska can get by without any help. If they win tonight, they're the champs, no matter what happens anywhere else.
Touchdown! from Costa for the score. 97-yard Miami drive. Remember, it began on their own 3-yard line. Pruitt for the extra point. It's good.
The flanker screen with the other receivers blocking against man coverage, almost impossible to defend. Charlie McBride, the defensive coordinator, said this play should be outlawed. And when Trent Jones gets in the open field,
And the hurricane warnings are up. 10-0, Miami. Five-man defensive front for Miami. Play action, Berenger rolls, flips, caught, touchdown, Gilman. Season. This one to Mark Gilman. His second touchdown catch. Extra point by Sealer up. And good. So Nebraska goes 40 yards in 5 plays. Berenger with a 19-yard toss to Gilman.
Berenger with the play action fake and the passing game of Nebraska getting them right back in the game.
It's a 3-point Orange Bowl.
Coach, it started off slowly. What turned it around for you in the first half?
Well, Ike, we try to play physical football, and we're hoping that we'll continue to get stronger as the game goes along. We need to hang on the ball on offense, get some first downs, keep their defense on the field. I think our defense is getting a little bit more confidence. We're getting a little more pressure on Costa. We just hope we can hang in there and pull it out.
Who's your quarterback in the second half?
Brooke Behringer will start.
Thank you, Coach. Good luck.
Holding their ground this time now, beginning to creep a little bit, as you see. No blitz. Costa's pass to a wide open Harris. Jonathan Harris cuts back. He's to the 15. To the outside. Harris racing for the end zone. Touchdown. Against Miami.
Tom, that may well have been for excessive celebration after the touchdown. In that case, the touchdown will stand.
So excessive celebration, the touchdown will stand, the penalty will come on the kickoff.
But that was the matchup we talked about at the beginning of the game. Jonathan Harris one-on-one against anybody. When we talked to him, he said, I want to be the man. Get me the football, especially against that man coverage. They cannot cover me.
First catch of the day for Harris goes for 44 yards. Jonathan Harris, the senior from Houston, Texas. Third leading receiver on the season, as Miami typically spreads the ball around. Here's the extra point attempt by Pruitt. High snap. Chrissy got it down. Pruitt boots it through. The quick strike, Miami offense, this time in the person of Jonathan Harris.
Jonathan Harris against the safeties from Nebraska. It cannot work for Nebraska.
Frank Costa celebrates another touchdown pass. It puts the Canes up by 10. Five wide receivers, nobody back there but Costa in the end zone. Being chased, and that'll be a safety. Blaine Harris, the senior from Bessemer, Alabama, with his sixth sack for the season and a safety, 2 points for the Cornhuskers.
Well, you call for it and Dwayne Harris delivers. Here's a guy with a 7-foot wingspan. And watch him stick out one of those big paws and make the play on Frank Costa. They say that he reminds him of Neil Smith, the great from the Kansas City Chiefs. Gonna send out that big hook and just pull him down with one arm. And now Nebraska has some much needed momentum. Good outside move. Sort of a scary picture, isn't it?
It
to
is
see one of those big guys coming at you.
From ground level. So the sack in the end zone, the safety, and now Miami will free kick from the 20-yard line.
And don't forget the 2-point conversion in college football, so only a touch.
Third and short, they threw deep. Chasing, and he kicks it out of bounds through the end zone. That'll be an illegal kick. Pruitt saw it sail 5 feet over his head. Barrier still has it after the play action. For the end zone, dangerous. Was it intercepted? Yes! Earl Little!
Field pressure. And Phillips up to 90 yards rushing.
Schlesinger. Touchdown. Trail 17-15. Full house backfield. Frazier will throw. It's good. 2-point conversion. Eric Alford made the catch. Game tied at 17.
And redemption for Tommy Frazier.
And a smile for Brooke Barrier.
For Tom Osborne. They have been forgetting about Schlesinger throughout the game. They were playing the option. And then Tommy Frazier. He can't throw. He can't throw. It's tied.
Spring suddenly back in the step of Coach Tom Osborne. The body English didn't work.
And we're sorry we can't give you Joe Paterno's reaction.
Well, 10 years ago in the 50th Orange Bowl Classic, Nebraska trailed Miami 31-30 after scoring a touchdown with 48 seconds left to play. Tom Osborne went for the win. 2-point conversion knocked away by Miami, and the Canes came away with their first national championship.
Yeah, boy, here we go. Gutsy call, brought Frazier back in, and now he has this Cornhusker offense on the move.
Less than 3 minutes remaining. Nebraska already in field goal range. See it. Schlesinger has another touchdown. Schlesinger broke free and took it in.
this year it's Tom Osborne, and this should do it. Batted in the air by Moss, who cradles it. And now, with Miami out of timeouts, the Cornhuskers, who held Miami this quarter with no first downs, will go on to win. It's just a matter of time now. And Tom Osborne, who so much...
Coming, what does it mean to you?
Well, it means a lot. I'm really proud of the players. Played a great game, a lot of heart.
You've come close, quarter. Coach, you've come close many times. Are you all more sweeter now?
Well, it's enjoyable. Let's put it that way.
Did you somehow feel that this was your year coming into the game?
I thought in the fourth quarter we'd be the best team, and we were. That's great.
What was the difference today?
Well, I mean, just we're probably in good condition, maybe a little stronger physically in the fourth quarter. Miami has a great team.
I gotta get in. Congratulations, Coach. Terrific victory.
Thank you.
Tommy, back to you.
Okay, John. Top earns a national championship with a tough win over Miami in the Orange Bowl. Final score 24-17. Bob Costas.
All right, Tom and Chris and John Dockery.
We're gonna be safe. I don't think they're gonna attack us. Back there? In the corner?
Oh, yeah. They're all getting in line.
Maybe you're on campus.
open your eyes.
Sue, come on.
Kenneth.
Who wants to be away? Get Sue real quick, please.
Go home.
All right.
You have to go like this, Michelle. Number one.
Lisa's. Bam.
Lisa, give him a shot.
Yay!
He was just telling him what to do.
Thank you.
No.
Thank you.